If we want to understand and describe surface texture, we need to get our arms around a concept of separating a surface like the one we see on the screen into the components of roughness and waviness. And when we talk about filtering, we're talking about separating roughness and waviness. So let's set this up together. If I look at this surface and kind of zoom my attention in on this zone right here on the left, I could calculate an average in this zone and then move the zone along the surface and keep calculating averaging. That's exactly what a filter does, only we're going to put a little more math or a little more science around that. What we're going to do is we're going to choose a width of this window so that we can always do it the same, and that width is related to the wavelengths where we separate roughness and waviness. In fact, as you see right now on the screen, we've set up a width of 0.8 millimeters. Now, this isn't just any averaging over 0.8 millimeters. We're going to do a special kind of average. We're going to use a Gaussian weighted average. That means the points in the middle are going to get more credit than the points out on the edges. So we can see that bell curve to say how much importance are we giving those points along the way. So if I calculated the average height of every point of the surface in that zone and gave them weighting or credit according to that Gaussian curve, I would end up with a point right here. That point on the screen is the first point of waviness. And now we can slide this along the surface and create waviness at every point along the profile. Now we'll notice that the waviness kind of ends before the actual blue data does. That's because the width of that averaging needs points on both sides to calculate a point in the middle. So we've created a waviness profile. That's the terminology. And in this case, we've created it for a 0.8 millimeter filter cutoff wavelength. But we can also use this concept now, and we can use this waviness profile to show or create roughness. So let's set this up again, and we'll see that we're going to slide our moving average of waviness along the surface. But now on the bottom, we're plotting the difference. Everything above and below the waviness profile is plotted as roughness. In fact, that is the definition of roughness. The roughness is everything that deviates from waviness. And from that black roughness profile we see at the bottom, we can now compute our roughness parameters. So we have an RA of 0.15 micrometers or an RZ of 1.08 micrometers. So this is interesting. This is the foundation of surface texture, and we've chosen a filter of 0.8 millimeters, and that relates to the width of our moving average. But let's switch gears. What if we look at this surface again, but instead of looking at a 0.8 millimeter filter cutoff, let's base our world on a 0.25 millimeter filter cutoff. So in this case, quarter of a millimeter wavelengths are going to be the separator between roughness, the fine details, and waviness, the lumpy details. In this case, our first average point would appear right here. And once again, we can slide this filtering across the surface to create a quite different waviness profile. This waviness profile has a lot more ripples or a lot more short wavelength information than our previous surface did. And as a result, we're going to see less roughness on the roughness side. So let's slide this filter through and produce waviness again. And the deviations above and below the red waviness line are now showing up in black at the bottom, and we have lower roughness values. So changing the filter cutoff, perhaps on a drawing or in your gauge settings, is actually changing the amount of smoothing that goes into waviness. And that difference in the amount of smoothing is going to change our roughness numbers. Now, just a quick rule of thumb, we talk about the 0.8 millimeter filter quite a lot. In the imperial unit world, that's 30 thousandths of an inch. That's roughly the thickness of your thumbnail. Keep in mind, when we filter, we're not just filtering for roughness. The waviness profile can be very, very important as well. So using that waviness knowledge can help us in many areas like sealing or vibration or even contact stresses or stripes that we see. So don't throw away the waviness as we're thinking about filtering for roughness. For more information, check out the Digital Metrology website. We have a lot of information on surface analysis, or just reach out to us. We love to talk about this stuff, and we'd love to help you solve your problems as well.